There are lots of English verbs to speak about things to do with our eyes. Some of these verbs are to look at, to see, to watch, to look for, to take a look at. The list goes on. I'm going to look at some of the main Spanish verbs used to translate some of these things, looking at lots of examples, of course, to help with your understanding. So the first verb I'm going to look at, one of the main ones and most common verbs, is ver. Okay, so the verb ver, I'm sure you've heard it before. And one of the main translations of ver is to watch. Okay, so to watch TV, to watch shows, to watch films. Ayer en la noche vimos dos películas. So yesterday night we watched two films. But another meaning of the verb ver can be to see as well. So to see something, to spot something. Cuando corre, siempre ve muchas ovejas. Okay, so when he runs, he always sees lots of sheep. Okay, yeah, quite random, I know, but it works. He always sees, he always spots them with his eyes. He's not kind of intensely watching them, he just sees them. And another example would be, hoy hace mucho sol, no podemos ver nada. So today it's very sunny. We can't see anything. So we don't have the ability to see anything. So that would be ver. Okay, so to watch and also to see. Another one of our common verbs is mirar. Okay, and the first meaning of mirar would be to look. Okay, so if I'm saying to someone, oh, look at something, I would use mirar. Mira, hay una mariposa. So look. There's a butterfly. So mira, the imperative there, is a very common use of this verb, mirar. Okay, so saying to someone, look, mira. Another meaning of mirar is to look at. Okay, so we have to look, but to look at as well. And if it means to look at, we don't need a preposition. We don't say mirar a, okay? It's just mirar. We don't need any preposition there. And an example sentence in this meaning would be, vamos a mirar tus fotos. We are going to look at your photos. So mirar tus fotos, not mirar a. Just mirar tus fotos. Okay. Our third common verb is going to be buscar. Okay, so buscar is much narrower in its meanings and it usually means to look for or to search for. And like when we have mirar meaning to look at, buscar doesn't have a preposition. We don't have buscar para to look for. It's just buscar, okay? So a next sentence would be, estoy buscando un nuevo libro. So I am looking for a new book. I'm searching for a new book. Okay? Estoy buscando un nuevo libro. So those are our three most common verbs we've got. But I'm also going to give you a new phrase which you might not have heard before to speak about things we do with our eyes. Okay. And this phrase is echar un vistazo. The main meaning of this phrase is to take a look. Okay, so take a quick look at something, doing something quickly, just glancing at something. Echamos un vistazo a su celular. Okay, so we took a look at his or her mobile phone. So in that case, we do need that app for the app. But it can also mean to take a look at, as in to look over something. So more intensely looking at something, whether it's a report, some homework, or a task, anything like that, can be to look over. Lo echaré un vistazo mañana. So I'll take a look at it tomorrow, or I'll look over it tomorrow. So we've got four different verbs and phrases there. So I hope that's really helpful. I hope that clears up the meanings of these different verbs and the different circumstances when you would use them. If you've liked this video, please give the video an actual like below. And yeah, I will catch you in the next video.